Mr. Henry and the Black and Tan Dog, Chapter 1. Mr. Henry liked to be alone. There are many things that he liked about being alone. Being alone is quiet. Because Mr. Henry liked the quiet so very much, he had chosen to buy a house far outside of town, where he knew no random passerby or salesperson might reasonably come by accident, and where he was certain no one would come on purpose. Mr. Henry had put quite a lot of thought into all of the things that were good about being alone. Being alone means you get to do exactly what you want to do when you want to do it. When Mr. Henry would make a chicken, he would save the wishbone, and because he was alone, he always got his wish. When Mr. Henry made pie, he always got the biggest piece. When Mr. Henry watched television, he always got to pick his favorite TV show. Mr. Henry never had to wait his turn to take a shower or go to the bathroom. As you can see, there are many good things about being alone, and Mr. Henry was quite content this way. Until one quiet Sunday morning, something changed. It began with a soft scraping on the front door. Mr. Henry was so unaccustomed to unexpected sounds that he stood there with a quizzical look on his face for nearly a full minute before investigating where the sound was coming from. As the scraping continued, he followed the sound until it arrived at the front door. He looked through the peephole and did not appear to see anything. He opened the door and only then saw a small black and tan dog standing in front of him. The dog had floppy ears that pricked up as the door opened. Upon seeing Mr. Henry, the dog's ears flattened slightly and her tail tucked just a bit as she took in the scowling man in front of her. She uttered one small, playful howl, partly to break the awkward tension she was feeling and partly to determine if this man was as curmudgeonly as he seemed. The sight of a random dog on his doorstep, however, left Mr. Henry quite speechless. Perhaps this was also because Mr. Henry had not spoken words to another living being in over 3 months. Unless screaming at the crows to stay out of his garbage counts, in which case that ritual typically occurs each Monday evening when he walks his garbage down the quarter mile long dirt road out to where the street pickup for the garbage is. One might even wonder if he looked forward to the Monday evening garbage trek and an opportunity to shout obscenities at the hungry crows, but I digress. The last time he properly spoke to another living being was 3 months ago, and then only to make a call for his standard grocery deliveries to be corrected because the milk had been missing from his most recent order. Mr. Henry even had his grocery orders left on the front stoop with a request for the doorbell not to be rung. Mr. Henry very much appreciated his quiet solitude and no interruptions. This dog was most definitely an interruption and an uninvited one at that. Mr. Henry promptly slammed the door in the dog's face. "Not my dog, not my problem," Mr. Henry said as he walked back to the kitchen to finish preparing his morning coffee. And then it began, the sound that started as a low, slow howl and grew into a mournful refrain as the black and tan dog sang a sad song of her woeful journey. While Mr. Henry did not speak dog, there was something in the howling that touched him, or perhaps the noise merely upset his typically unpleasant demeanor, or perhaps he just wanted the dog to shut up. Whatever the reason, Mr. Henry went back to the front door and, against his better judgment, opened it. He was ready to tell the dog to get on its way and stop disturbing his quiet, but there was something in the dog's eyes as he opened the door. Something sad, something pleading was what he saw. And so, against his better nature, he did not shout the dog off the porch. Instead, he opened his mouth, cleared his throat, and attempted to remove the cobwebs that must surely be hanging there from disuse. And he barked at the dog, "What do you want?" The dog began to wag her tail and came towards Mr. Henry and licked his hand. Mr. Henry's immediate reaction was one of disgust as he recoiled away from the dog. He had no idea where this dog came from and what diseases it might possibly be carrying. There was also a different feeling, though, an altogether unfamiliar one, something sort of warm, and that as he thought about it, he vaguely remembered it from a long time ago. Then Mr. Henry did something that even shocked himself. He invited the dog inside.